many people in the audience think that Knuffle Bunny is a true story? Raise your hand. Oh, all right. How many people think that I made up the story of Knuffle Bunny? Raise your hand. Oh, yeah. All right. All right, here's the real answer. Everything in the Knuffle Bunny stories is true, except for the parts that I made up.
I love it. What an honor to have Mo Willems joining us this morning. Of course, there is a new special that is now streaming on HBO Max, and I had a chance to watch it this morning. And again, what an honor. I have three kiddos at home, and what an honor to have you joining us today.
Well, thank you. Thank you. Please give your kids all my best.
Yes, I will. I will. So tell me about this special. And again, you're just so beloved in the stories and your storytelling. I feel like even I was watching some of your YouTube clips of you reading. This is a bigger thing, I think, now in 2020, as celebrities and things were starting to read and pick this. You were doing this long before we started this in 2020.
Yeah, you know, what I hope for this special and the way and my performances and these comedians' performances, they're for the grown-ups. I'm trying to give you guys a shamectomy. It's a magic opportunity, story time. When you're with your kids, you get to be ridiculous. You get to be silly. You get to draw. You get to make up stories. That's magic. And I feel like we sometimes forget the power of silliness, that silliness allows us to connect in very, very deep and special ways.
Well, so, and you know what's awesome? So when I watched the special, that was what I thought of. Not only you, but all your special friends, the celebrity guests that joining you, you can tell they are enjoying, as you said, being silly and kind of embracing story time. And even because some of the people from Saturday Night Live, that's what they do, you know, for adults, right? I mean, it's kind of the same improv and kind of the same silliness that you do, you put into children's books.
That's exactly right. And, you know, for me, the show is the show. What I'm most interested in is what happens after the show. When you turn off that show, are you going to be reading differently? Are you going to be drawing with your kid? Are you going to be performing your favorite book like it's a sketch? That's my hope. That's where the magic is.
Oh, I love that. Well, and I think especially in a year like we've had in 2020, where maybe people aren't doing as much, maybe they're being, at, you know, they're at home a little bit more, where we aren't able to go to the places that we, books and reading and drawing, storytelling, that can take us anywhere in the world, can it not?
Absolutely. And I feel that, again, particularly in these times, the reason to be creative is not just because you're expressing yourself, it's because it helps you discover yourself. I need to draw and sketch to deal with the anxiety that just is everyday life right now. And those drawings help me to realize how I feel. And if I'm drawing in a particular way or drawing particular characters, I'm speaking to myself. So particularly now, I think it's important for grownups and kids to learn how they're feeling through creative acts.
You know, it's funny, I actually come from an art, my dad's an artist, and while I didn't go that route, I went into my own kind of version of storytelling. And it's funny how they really are so hand in hand, you know, maybe not necessarily creating, but the storytelling part of it, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, we are living stories. That is what we are.
So tell me, because this was actually shot, you were telling me, last year. So what have you been doing now, kind of, because I know you didn't stop being creative here in 2020. No, have you been working on other projects?
I'm working on all kinds of projects. You know, some stuff, obviously, I can't talk about. Right now, I am the artist in residence at the Kennedy Center, and we are doing an online project called the Small Works Project. I made 50 very small little pieces of art. And we are sending them to 50 different people who have done little things to make the world better. Maybe they've brought water to a protest, or maybe one guy yesterday helped renovate a school. Whatever that is, we want people to stand up and be proud of the little things they're doing. And we want to give them a little piece of art.
Oh, I love that. Where can people find out more? Is it on social media, I'm assuming?
It is, if you go to the Kennedy Center website, Kennedy Center/Mo Willems, you can see that and some of the other projects that we've been doing to try and get us through these difficult times.
Yeah. Hey, as we get ready to wrap up here, what is your take home for parents? And again, I absolutely love reading to my kids. And I think the more that you can feel energetic about it and really allow yourself to be silly with it. But I know that might be hard for some adults, right? When we get kind of too serious.
Here's the thing. I think that parents forget that they're cool. So if you want your kid to be creative, you have to be creative. They're going to watch you and they say, oh man, I want to do that. If your kid says, make me a sandwich, and you're like, not now, I'm drawing.
Ooh.
Drawing is cooler than sandwiches.
I like that answer. I'm going to use that this afternoon when they get home from school.
Excellent.
Well, Mo, what an honor to have you on the show this morning. Thank you so much. And certainly I know people can stream this on HBO Max, the new special. Again, you're going to find a lot of celebrity friends there. A lot of fun. But we appreciate it, Mo.
Thank you so much, Carly. Be well.
All right. Take care. You too.